Gerry Brownlee, Excellency, New Zealand High Commissioner to Fiji, Mark Ramsden, distinguished guests, Permanent Secretary, Commissioner of Police, and senior military officials, ladies and gentlemen. I am deeply honored and privileged to be here today to witness and, of course, receive on behalf of the Fiji government the four amphibious boats donated to Fiji by the New Zealand government's by the New Zealand's Ministry of Foreign Affairs, to the Ministry of Rural and Maritime Development and National Disaster Management. I know that this huge donation deserves a long speech, but I know, Excellency, that you are pressed for time. But let me once again warmly welcome you, Kia, Bulubunaka, good afternoon, and thank you for being here with us. And once again, let me convey to you our most sincere appreciation, and of course, congratulate you as well on your recent appointment. And we hope that we will continue to work together, particularly with our bilateral relationships. I know that you are not new in the area of disaster management, given your previous involvement in the Earthquake Commission, and of course the Canterbury earthquake recovery following the two events of 2010 and 2011. And of course, we briefly discussed in Wellington while I was there about the activities and of course the areas in which we can collaborate. And I'm indeed thankful that you are here with us. Again, the relationship between our two countries has been a long relationship. And of course, as Minister responsible for disaster management, let me just again recall some of the previous projects, the activities, not only since 2011, but of course, way back even beyond that. I have conveyed deep appreciation, while we were in New Zealand about the events after 2011 when we had T.C. Evans. And of course, the projects are still ongoing. From 2011 to 2015, the New Zealand government had also been funding our National Disaster Awareness Week. We want to do much in terms of awareness, but of course, funding is a big constraint for us. And the New Zealand government has been assisting us from 2011 to 2015, and even lately with the National Disaster Week. Of course, we are mandated under the 1988 Act to conduct the awareness. And of course, particularly as we come closer to our cyclone seasons. The New Zealand aid has also been assisting us through many years with the provision of $100,000 for that national event. Recently, the New Zealand government was also here for us in 2012 for T.C. Evans, Winston last year, and the Zina and Tropical Depression 04 Foxtrot late last year. From 2016, the New Zealand aid had further progressed, assisting us with two purposely built evacuation centers for the country, beginning in the Western Division in Narata in Nandunga. The Commissioner of Police is from Nandunga, Excellency, and of course in Masawi in Ra, and this will be opened later this year. I also need to mention the assistance that was provided to us by the New Zealand government during Cyclone Pam. We wanted to deploy and assist our new Vanuatu brothers, but unfortunately we lacked that strategic lift capability. But we are thankful again through the High Commissioner, we were able to be assisted, and this is one of the key areas that we are looking at, particularly in terms of our cooperation with the region. Major lessons learned from Winston last year, and I've shared this with my counterparts in New Zealand. One is the way we see things, because disasters and climate change is the new norm, and we need to shift our paradigm. We need to see things differently, because the way we see things with our paradigm will dictate the way we behave and the way we do things. The way we do development, that's very, very important, particularly for us now in climate change and, of course, in disaster, adaptation, resilience, This is very, very critical for us so that we can enjoy life and most importantly, bring about that macroeconomic resilience as well. So the way we do development is very, very critical for us now, not just doing development for the sake of development, but sustainable development in the long term. And most importantly, the way we cooperate. And for us, we play a role within the wider South Pacific region. And for that, we cannot work in isolation. Of course, we rely, as we witnessed during Cyclone Pam, and of course again in Cyclone Winston, that with the limited capabilities that we have, we rely heavily on Australia and New Zealand to provide that further assistance for us. And again, this is again enhancing our capability. We have been working on this since 2011, all the way back to 2009, when we made that strategic shift in terms of our policy and decision making, shifting from a culture of reaction to a culture of prevention. And for us to be able to deliver effectively and efficiently, we wanted to have the capabilities. It will bring a lot of relief to the people that we serve, and most importantly, bring confidence and trust to the people, particularly in the ambivalent state during their worst period. So, Excellency, this again will really boost our capability, and hopefully, maybe come another disaster in the region. This will not only be seen in Fiji, but we can also, as part of our deployment, as part of cooperation, we can also be deploying this in other parts of the region. But thank you once again, Excellency. I know that you have other activities this afternoon, but let me assure you that as Minister responsible, we will ensure that this is well utilized, and of course we'll ensure that the relevant governance systems and processes are in place so that this is not abused but used to the best, so that we can achieve maximum outcome out of these contributions. And once again, thank you indeed. Wish you well in your term as the new Foreign Affairs Minister, and we look forward to more visits as such for the future.